Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Hani Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this lesson, we are going to discuss the differences between dashboards and reports. You might have heard about this term dashboard or report, and you might not be aware the differences between them. So as we proceed with the project, we will be required to provide some reports like weekly, monthly. Also, reports will be submitted to different stakeholders, like we might submit report for our senior management or our client. So the differences between the stakeholders who are going to read your report will tell us whether the report should be very detailed, whether it should be a report or dashboard. This will be discussed now. So the reports are a formal records of summarized information. These reports usually contains more information than the dashboards. However, the report should be focused to the point and should have only the information required. Examples for the reports, we might have quality report. This project document includes quality management issues, recommendation for corrective actions, and summary for finding quality control activities. So this is called a report. This is a sample of a report, weekly progress report. Could have some information, some numbers, and so on. Another sample of a report is a risk report. This risk report will contain the risk issues and how going to respond for the risk. You might have risk response. This all consider as reports. A status report. This document also provides a report to the current status of the project. It might include information on progress since the last report or forecasting for the upcoming weeks. This is a sample of a report, which is monthly report, and this is a component of the monthly report. Another sample of reports that schedule performance. You might have here some main buildings, and you put the planned percentage, actual percentage, and you create summary information table, which include the shop drawing status or whatever important information you have. So all of these called reports. So let's summarize the reports. We have here the report could be daily report, weekly report, or monthly report. For example, the daily report is submitted in daily basis. It contains labor hours, equipment, material delivery, safety insights, task completion, and the benefit it is early detection of any issues and record all the daily actions on site. Weekly report will be cumulative progress reports and will focus on the milestone achievement, resource utilization, and the target audience will be different between daily report and weekly report, because daily report will be interested for foreman, supervisions, and the project managers, while weekly report might be more focused to the project manager, project teams, stakeholders. It will be also containing the planned productivity, challenges and solutions, upcoming milestones, and it is in weekly basis. The benefit of weekly report to keep record of the project and keep monitoring the progress of the project. However, the monthly report, since it will be issued in monthly basis, it should focus on more overall trends, risk assessment, delay analysis, and it could be directed to senior management or client or maybe investors, and maybe have more information than the weekly report, but specifically targeting the relevant stakeholders. There are too many samples of the reports. You can find too many shapes and samples where you can have in the daily report, for example, man hours, equipment detail, main activities, issues. This is a sample of a construction project daily report. So now we have an idea about the report. What about the dashboard? Dashboard, you can find it is more graphical than the reports. It can contain relevant information in a simple way. So here, this is a sample of a weekly progress dashboard, which will have progress percentage, actual versus planned, forecast finish date, delay activities, and also you might have another monthly report which contains the trends, the manpower, shop drawing status, and so on. For any of your report or dashboards, make sure that the report or the dashboard is focusing on the project. No need to add extra information or unnecessary information. You should report important KPIs like cost, time, quality. The report shouldn't have too many colors, because sometimes the colors itself will distract you from reading the report in a proper way, And the most important thing, be sure that your report doesn't have any misleading data. Sometimes the report looks like very nice or the dashboard looks very good, but it has misleading data, misleading information. This is very dangerous because from these reports, very serious actions could be taken. Are the reports the best way to present your data? You saw the differences between reports and dashboards. In my opinion, we should use the dashboard as much as we can in the senior level, and we can use the report in the daily tasks. Report is perfect. The audience interesting in enough and more data and numbers. In many cases, you might find yourself presenting to a stakeholder who is not much interested in this case. In that case, we should use the dashboard because it has no detailed information, high level numbers and main KPIs, and will attract the attention easily. Also, I would like to recommend that if you have a very important meeting and you have your dashboards, have also a backup reports for any details. Like if you said, okay, we are behind the schedule by 20%, then you might be asked, okay, from where this 20% came from? So in my opinion, don't include everything in your report, but keep a backup documents with you. So if you have a question like from where these numbers came from, or what are the details for this KPI, you will be ready to answer your stakeholders. So the dashboard collects the information from different parties and represent them in a graphical way or a simple way where it will be very easy to be used. Now let's see, what are the main components of a dashboard? Like we have stoplight charts, bar chart, by chart, guide charts. So we have too many things we are going to discuss, and also we are going to do it together in Excel. So stoplight chart is very simple. You can have like green, yellow and red, and it can be used for many things. Like green could be ahead of schedule, yellow on schedule, and red means something wrong behind the schedule. If we convert it to cost, it can be under cost, on budget or over budget. If we make the same for material delivery, for example, it could be on time, expected or late. So the concept of a stoplight is very nice to use in your dashboards. Also here we have the bar chart, a very nice graphical way to represent the numbers, like here delivered 31, this is 12, or you can also make too many charts together to represent some information. This is in a horizontal way. You can make it also in a vertical way to show your manpower or something. Pie chart also is very nice way of presenting data and percentage. I would like to use them very much with the shop drawing and material status, where you can say, okay, we have 70% approved shop drawing, 16% rejected, and 14% waiting for approval, for example. Or material status, you can say here we have approved material and this is a rejected material, this is a waiting for approval. Or you can say also the earned value, this is the earned value and this is the remaining value. You can use them. So this is very nice pie chart. Also I'm using a lot in my dashboards. And the gag chart is very nice because it will give you a focus on a number, like the actual percentage. Here you can see it clearly 60.1 and the planned is 64.2. It will give you a very nice indication, or you can use it like a speedometer here, showing you the percentage of your project or any other percentage. Do you see this nice dashboard? This very simple, although it is very effective. We are going to create it from scratch together. So in the next session, we will work on Excel together to see how we can do this nice dashboard. Very simple, very easy, and I'm sure you're going to like it. Hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in the next one.